17-year-old being charged with rioting and petrol bomb offenses on arson. The other is 38-year-old being charged with arson and hijacking of a timber truck. Only after week one of the unit floor sharing talks, any progress being made, our chief coordinating director has been trying to find out.
The tone's perhaps been set for these talks by Secretary of State Karen Bradley, who spoke at Stormontown earlier this week.
This is not going to be easy, and I've got an answer that we all need to talk to. Time and space. On that basis, I'm not going to make any further comments.
During the process of the talks, so far we've not heard from the parties on how the talks have gone, so they may be taking their leave from Bradley. Sinn Féin President Meadows is due to speak with Prime Minister Theresa May on Monday note. Meanwhile, Thomas has signed a company for COVID and said he feels there has been some movement so far. He told reporters earlier this week that the parties are coming at it with the right mentality.
Certainly all of the parties and their political leaders, I think, were very constructive. But clearly we have a lot of work to do. And I think everybody recognises that there's work to do to accommodate each other.
Politicians will be engaged in smaller working groups, a new approach, but with the British and Irish governments also reviewed at the end of May, that might explain the media silence so far.
Thousands have taken part in suicide awareness events across Northern Ireland this morning. 12 dark visits or a walk took place here in the Army Hours. This year's campaign, called The Power of Hope, aims to remove the stigma from suicide and self-harm. Now, two sisters from Northern Ireland booked a trip of a lifetime recently when Gary Barlow drove them to Cape Mad concert. Lucy and Haley Abbott were on route to a gig when their bus broke down. This is what happened next.
We get off the bus and suddenly the busy cars just pull up and three members of the band came down to get out, and obviously we were just completely overwhelmed and shocked. So we run in and got a hug on them, and then we find out that Katie and myself were getting those 20 minute car journey with Gary Barlow.
After just 8 months in charge, the Bord an Gallant Swift boss took over from Mark Kearney last September after he joined the Ferris. That's your lead in from downtown Kill FM News. It's been okay.
Very well done, Cleo, all the way there for Fergus Glory.